Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of a little show we'd like to call Gamer's Paradise, brought to you by One Esports and Marriott Bonvoy. Like it says on the tin, we do our best to bring you a slice of virtual utopia every week, and this is your go-to for gameplay boosts and must-attend hangouts with your favorite esports and gaming personalities. Take on challenges that only gamer geeks can solve and gain valuable insights from the people you aspire to be in the gaming industry. And don't worry, you won't even have to fight over the controller here because we've got something for everyone. My name is Ari.
Too much coffee?
A little bit. I'm just a little hyped. Yeah, I'm a little hyped. I'm excited for this episode.
It's a little obvious.
I'm excited for this episode.
You know what else is obvious?
You're taller.
Yes! Thank you!
You're
taller. Thank you!
Without the box, without the Apple box.
No box needed.
Is this a breakthrough?
Yeah. You didn't want to see the Apple box, so fine. I made my own way.
We're growing.
Yeah. If Ari is player one, I am inevitably player two. My name is Mika Fabs. And on top of all that prime gaming content, we are going to be taking you to some top tier facilities around Asia, the best places to kick back and relax. Again, that's why we are called Gamer's Paradise.
That's right, Mika. Today, the Gamer's Paradise Spotlight is on retro gaming. I'm excited for that. And we're winding it back from old school, from discussing iconic heroes to playing a guessing game that reveals more than just your gaming knowledge. We've got a jam-packed itinerary ahead of you. So ladies and gentlemen, first up, there's a spirited debate on gaming first, coming in just a little bit on the Pulse.
We also have a relaxing catch-up with YouTuber and famed Japanese announcer Shinya Sunagawa on Gamer's Haven. Oh, wait, that was a bit too big of a hit.
She does that. She spoils. She has it. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be chatting with gaming content creator, vlogger, comedian, and fellow otaku GLOCO on Hero Story. I'm excited to have him.
I can't wait to meet him.
He's a friend. He's a good dude.
Heard so many good things. Okay, so I didn't give away that much. There's still a lot more in store. Anyhow, we also have a new fun party game later, retro game character Pictionary. You are going to want to get your paper and colored pens ready for that. I know mine are. I'm very ready for this. But for now, let's say we hold our precious joysticks and consoles of choice close as we throw down our latest edition of The Pulse. Let's join Ari in greeting today's guest.
We are back on the segment of our show where we invite two amazing guests to talk about the hottest gaming topics and to tell us what they really think and feel about them. And since we are on a retro game episode for Gamer's Paradise today, let me introduce our first guest. Of course, next to me, we have host, variety streamer, content creator, and cosplayer, Aya Ezmaria. Thank you for joining us. Thank you very much.
And of course, thank you for having me.
Very, very cool. Thank you. And of course, also next to me, we have content creator from Singapore, and we'll choose to get an iPad through hard mode, ladies and gentlemen, Keiji.
Hello, hello from Singapore.
Welcome, welcome. Thank you very much, my friend. So really, really quick, our topic is who, for you, is the most iconic retro video game character ever? Now, retro is subjective, so I know, of course, retro depends. Mm. It's very subjective. Yeah. But first console, Aya.
Famicom.
Famicom, nice. What was your first console, KG?
The Nintendo 64.
Oh, that's older, actually.
Oh, calling you old. Okay.
No.
Okay, look at you going Nintendo 64. Okay, so Famicom's a little bit more like, I had a good boy, actually.
Yeah.
That's what I had growing up. I didn't even get a Famicom. But Aya, to open, who do you feel is the most iconic video game, retro video game character ever?
You know, there is no amount of preparation to be prepared for this very day because there are so many iconic game characters out there, but there can only be one, as you guys said. And since I can only have one, it would definitely be Lara Croft.
Lara Croft. All right. Okay.
Lara Croft within this show. Yes, it's Tomb Raider, baby.
That's right. Look what KG's doing right now. Look, I like what he's doing. He's like, Lara Croft? Who is this Lara Croft?
Like, you're a dude. How can you not like Lara Croft?
Okay. No. Okay, KG.
I respect the woman's rights, you know, we're all about the woman advocating woman power and everything. But Lara Croft, no. If you gave me like Super Mario, I would accept that, you know?
Okay.
But my pick, Pikachu.
Pikachu? So pabebe. Do you know what's pabebe?
Pabebe.
What is pabebe?
Do you know what that means?
Well, pabebe is basically, you know, say what it is.
Pa-chicks, pa-girl.
Pa-chicks, pa-girl. You're just in it for the girls, man. That's what he's saying.
You want an iconic character to be cute. Hence, iconic.
Who said that? Which part of like Google or Wikipedia can you find? In Wikia said that iconic character has to be cute.
Valid argument. Okay. So if retro character is not supposed to be cute, so you're saying she has to be like sultry or sexy?
Yes, and badass.
And badass, right? That's why Lara is the most iconic.
Yeah.
What are the iconic things that Lara has done?
A lot of things like saving the world before bedtime or raiding tombs. And, you know, what else is there to say? Would you rather have a rat with electrocution powers to snuggle with than with a badass lady who can actually defend and protect you? Well, her butler cook you dinner.
Okay, listen, Aya called Pikachu a rat.
I did.
The thing is, it is a very accurate description of Pikachu. But we're talking about retro game. Meaning, we're talking about Lara Croft with pixelated and it's triangular. You want
polygonal.
That with you? If you talk about the most recent Lara Croft, I'm down. Uh-huh. I'm with you. But retro game? No. The thing is, Pikachu is so iconic. It's saying its own name. If you show a picture of Pikachu, and you show a picture of Lara Croft, 90% of people out there will say, that's Pikachu.
That's basically saying, Aya, that no one would recognize Lara, but everyone recognizes Pikachu.
Everyone in this room can recognize Lara Croft from afar.
That's what he said, okay.
I could show you a picture of Lara Croft right now, and everyone will know that is Lara Croft right there.
Yeah. I mean, if we talk about stats as well, the number of Lara Croft games, how many are there?
I think 7, Five? 8.
Six?
Is it six?
It's a lot.
Pokemon has over 20 games.
20.
All with Pikachu.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. But Pikachu was not in all of those games, especially in the recent ones, like Pokemon Arceus. There's so many new generations where Arceus. Pikachu is not even his own protagonist in his own game. Mm. Come on. Mm. It's just a side character.
Side character. Oh my God. He's calling Pikachu someone who abandoned his franchise, Keiji.
No.
Exactly. Lara is like the main protagonist in all of those 6 or 7 franchise. Quality versus quantity, you know?
So you're saying Pikachu doesn't have any commitment?
Yeah, exactly what I'm saying right now.
Calling Pikachu unfaithful.
There is no movies, commitment. There is a whole anime franchise as well. It's all together. If you talk about the anime series, Pikachu has been Ash since 10, over 20 years, start of the anime, you know?
Yeah, 2D animations, but let me give you two words.
Okay.
Two words for this
two
one.
Words.
Angelina Jolie, that's
Boom.
All you need. Angelina Jolie.
You're saying that was the it's iconic because she played, of course, Tomb Raider, and who played Pikachu?
Let me give you two words.
Okay.
Okay.
Ryan Reynolds.
What?
Detective Pikachu.
Ryan Reynolds. Detective Pikachu. Okay. That's true, yes.
You know, I didn't watch that because I would rather have Ryan Reynolds in Deadpool.
Sexiest man alive.
Both have beautiful bodies, yes. She was the sexiest woman. He was the sexiest man.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
But still, I would rather, again, have Ryan Reynolds in Deadpool than Ryan Reynolds in a voiceover of Pikachu in Detective Pikachu. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Anyway, why don't you close up the argument with Pikachu, Keiji?
All right, so I may come from a biased point because I am actually half Japanese. Mm-hmm. So I really... Yeah. The passion is there.
We feel it.
So I do feel that, especially in Singapore, when Pokemon Go came out, last time you would say, maybe only kids know Pikachu, but now even the aunties, the uncle, it goes way beyond that. And everyone may not know all the Pokemon, but Pikachu, that is iconic.
Well, okay, fine. You have good points. And Pokemon did stood the test of time. You know, everybody knows it. Everybody wants to snuggle with Pikachu. But let me just give you this, that Lara Croft from Tomb Raider actually set the tone and gave way to all of the most iconic female heroines in gaming history. That's how you win an argument. That's how you win an argument.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah. So, ladies and gentlemen, we hope you all enjoyed that argument here on The Pulse. Aya, thank you very much. KG, you became emotional. thank you very much. That was very heated argument, but we really appreciate that. Huge heartfelt thanks to both of you. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for dropping by The Pulse. We still have you guys to the house party. Of course, we'll have you guys for the house party. All that bad blood, use it, okay? Put it over to the house party a little bit later. So, ladies and gentlemen, nice catching up with our childhood memories, but we will now be taking a epic detour courtesy of my co-host, Mika, with side quests.
Ah, sounds like you guys had such a blast reminiscing. I'm not going to keep you too long so you can go back to thinking about your first video game experiences and maybe tell us about them. But before that, let's get started on today's side quest. As you may already know, in this segment, we feature premier video games with beautifully detailed world maps that are, can you believe it, inspired by real-life locations. Locations that you and I can actually add to our own bucket lists. Throughout the show, we'll give you clues, and all you have to do is guess which game we're talking about in the comments section. So yep, that means it's time for our first clue. This beloved video game franchise has been around for 15 years, and its recent installment came out in November 2020. This series is also best known for real-world historical events and figures that are used to hype up the game's fictional narrative. Was that too vague, or do you have an idea which game we're talking about on this edition of SideQuest? After the break, we'll be enjoying some hearty laughs with Shinya Sunagawa as we admire the sights at Moxy Tokyo Kinshicho on Gamer's Haven. Then, GLOCO will be delighting us with stories of his life as one of the most famous YouTube content creators out there. All that and more when Gamer's Paradise returns in just a few.
We are not here on this planet to close our eyes to the world.
We are here to go out and experience its many wonders.
Because through our experiences,
we become bigger than ourselves.
Travel has the power to shape our world
and make us whole again.
With 30 hotel brands and endless experiences, where can we take you?
Some more retro discussions for everyone out there. Did you like the Pulse? Did you see them going at it?
I love it. I thought they were going to start a full-blown like PvP at one point, but I love reminiscing as well.
It was a lovely discussion. Uh-huh. It got emotional, but we're back, and here we are.
Yes, indeed. Do you notice anything special about this segment, by the way?
Mika.
What?
Why did you bring back the Apple Box?
I did not bring back the Apple Box. Do you see an Apple Box? I don't see.
Standing on a giant carpet hill.
There is no Apple Box, Ari. This is just a retro flashback of
yours.
We
were all so proud of you.
This is you. Didn't nostalgic.
She have a breakthrough? Right?
You were nostalgic for like episode 2 or wherever that was.
All right, just stand on your invisible stealth Apple Box. But anyway, jumping from Mika's invisible Apple Box to Gamer's Haven, we are going to learn more about YouTuber and announcer Shinya Sunagawa, having amassed a large community of subscribers on his platform. This guy knows all about keeping his fans and fellow gamers happy, and we join Shinya as he takes a breather at Moxy Tokyo Kinshicho.
こんにちは、砂川慎也と申します。普段はクイズ番組に出たりだとか、YouTube に動画上げたりしてます。 よろしくお願いします。ゲームって自分が参加できることが一番大きいと思っていて、いろんなエンタメが世の中、映画だったりだとかアニメだったりとかたくさんありますけど、ゲームは自分が主人公になって、この現実世界とは別の世界に入り込んで、好きなように例えばビーム打ったりだとか技出したりだとか、そうやって自分が主人公になってその世界を堪能できるというところがすごく刺激的で楽しいなと思います。ゲーム機のなんかやっぱりプレイステーションとかですかね。やっぱりなんか PC でも、僕 PC であんまりゲーム遊んだことないっていうのはあるんですけど、なんかなんていうかな、自分の中でその自分の人生においてやっぱりゲームするって、まあ、携帯、今では携帯とか PC とかできますけど、やっぱりゲーム機があってその中にソフトを入れてコントローラー握ってゲーム遊ぶっていう体験がもうなんか身に染みてると言いますか、それが一番しっくりくるので、僕はゲーム機が一番好きです。僕は結構昔からポケモンシリーズをすごくやっていて、それもただ遊ぶんじゃなくて、なんか制限をつけて縛りを加えて遊んだりだとか、あとはもうそのゲームの中にあるものすごく難しいモードがあるんですね、そういうものに挑戦したりとかしてます。縛りつけるのは例えばその何と言いますか、ポケモンが倒されてしまったらそのポケモンはもうずっと使えないだとか、そういうスリルを加えて遊んだりだとかしてますね。そういう意味で多分一番長くやってますね、ポケモンが。ポケットモンスターエメラルドっていう、その結構前のゲームなんですけど、2003年とか4年ぐらいのゲームなんですけど、今もやってます。ゲームボーイアドバンス SP ですね。今日も持ってきてるんですけど、上にあって。そうですね、ポケモン結構昔、もう二十何年も前からあるようなレトロゲームだと思うんですけど、その楽しさの本質みたいなものは今も変わってなくて、逆に言ってしまえば今こんだけ年月が経ってるのに、今すごく楽しめる遊べるゲームの面白さの本質がそういうレトロゲームの頃からあったっていう、そういう意味では本当に面白いものってなかなか世の中ないと思うんですけど、それが昔からあったという意味ですごく貴重な作品で、すごくそういう意味でも面白い作品が昔からあったんだなって思いますね。受験の時にゲームやめることですね。本当にやめたのは合格する前の1年とかなんですけど、まあね、ちょくちょくたまにやったりとかしましたけど、やっぱりそうなんかずっと毎日遊んでくるのが当たり前みたいな感じだったんで、そういう意味ではそういう習慣を断ち切るっていうのは苦労しましたね。最近大学が忙しいっていうのもあってあまりできてなかったりもするんですけど、でもやるときは1日1時間ぐらいやってるのかな、週ちょっと今はすごい忙しいんで 2,3 時間とかですけど、やるときは本当にそれこそエルデンリングハマってたときは週70時間ぐらいやってましたね。イヤホンですね。これモバイルバッテリーですね。これメガネです。僕目悪いんで。これ任天堂スイッチでございます。本が一冊とマスクと、厚刈りなんでうちわも持ってます。あとこれが双眼鏡ですね。これなんか旅先とかで遠くとか見るときとかに使うと楽しいです。双眼鏡とスピーカーとお水と、これ Nintendo 2DSLL って言うんですけど、 3DS のゲームができます。こちらがゲームボーイアドバンス SP ですね。こんな感じです。あまり目標とかは僕はあまり持ってなくて、そういう意味では自分が一番楽しむっていうのは大事にしてますね。やっぱりなんか例えばなんかその人のためとか、なんかお金のためにやってるような人もいるかもしれないですけど、結局自分が一番楽しんでるのが 一番かなという意味で、そういう意味でそれを見てる人もなんだかんだ一番楽しめるのかなという意味で、あまりなんかこれをしたい、ああいうことを達成したいというよりも、何よりも自分が一番楽しむってことしか考えてないです。そういう仕事を目指す人ってなんか自分の中になんか燃えたぎるアイデアじゃないですけど、情熱みたいなのがあると思うんですよね。そういうものをなんか形にしたりだとか言葉にしたりすごく難しいと思うんですけど、悩み抜きながらその情熱を全部ぶつけてほしいですね。
Thank you for showing us around, Shinya-san. You know, you're just talking. I haven't been to Tokyo yet. I've been to Japan, but not Tokyo. Oh my gosh. And now after that, I want to go so bad.
Definitely, and definitely see the sights on that. Thank you, Shinya-san, for showing us around. Now, how about we switch it up a little bit, Mika? Because now we have a special someone who is our guest, ladies and gentlemen, for Hero Story. It is my pleasure to introduce one of the OGs in, of course, gaming here in the country. And also, we would love to hear more about his story of what came to be, how he started. A horror game connoisseur, the founder of Pinoy's Realm, and definitely took streaming to the Philippines to a whole new level with, of course, the things he's done. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome GLOCO!
Yo, what's up, guys? My name is GLOCO. Wow, horror game connoisseur.
That's
yeah,
that.
I do eat horror games for dinner, guys.
You do that.
All
that's
the time.
Your thing. That is your thing.
Unfortunately.
Unfortunately. Yes. But you gave some really good suggestions. But first off, I have to ask GLOCO. Okay, so you are a fisherman.
Yes.
And a streamer. Mm-hmm. I mean, how did that come to be? You actually mentioned that streaming came first and that led you to fishing?
Actually, gaming came first. Like, I was a gamer. I played some fishing games, and then I was like, hey, I want to fish in the IRL. I want to catch this beautiful-looking trout someday in the future. So that's where I got my fishing enthusiasm. And then after that, I think I went back to just gaming and being sad because I can't fish.
It was calling to you.
Yeah, he loves his fish. No, but also, if I know people know this as well, or for those who didn't, nursing, being a nurse was also something that you were set to do, but you switched to gaming eventually. Mm-hmm. How did it happen?
So, I started off as a frustrated nursing student. I got through that for 4 years, and then after I graduated, I had this idea, you know, the typical college, fresh graduate college student, where, man, I wanna take 1 year off, just doing my thing, or just laying down in my bed, or, I don't know, soul searching.
Yeah.
So that, to me, was streaming, or playing video games and doing Let's Play videos. 'Cause
at this point, streaming wasn't a thing yet.
It wasn't a thing in the Philippines.
Yes.
But it was like a long time thing already in, what do you call it, in the Western, I don't know, the Western region.
Yeah.
I was a particular fan of PewDiePie.
Pewds.
So, yeah, that was what pretty much everyone was doing. They were just watching PewDiePie back in college. So I figured that nobody's doing this in the Philippines yet. And I have 1 year that my parents fortunately approved of. So I decided, hey, maybe I'll try streaming, or rather doing Let's Play videos, recording myself, commentating on video games, and let's see where it goes. And at the side of while doing that, I had to think about how to support myself. Because
what did you do?
I promised my parents that, hey, for you guys to actually approve of this, I devise a plan that I won't ask for anything from you guys. Just don't pester me about going back to nursing for 1 year. Just,
for one year.
Just give
me
1 year. I'll do everything myself. So I got like a part-time job as an English teacher for Japanese students that fortunately paid for the bills for 1 year. And then after 1 year of doing the Let's Play thing, fortunately, it ended up pretty good. Like I saw results, and it was enough to keep me going for another year, and then the year after that, it just kept growing and growing, and here I am.
When did it become monetary? Like, after how long before you said, oh, I don't have to teach English
anymore? Yeah, yeah. This can be my career. Yeah. When was that moment?
I think it was like 2 years after I started that it started going over what I usually earn from the English teaching stuff. And it was getting a lot more fun. And I was able to create like a dedicated community that just watches whatever I put out. So at that point, it was kind of surreal.
Nice.
And I just said that, hey, I'll just do this full time. Like, why not? Might as well. So there.
Oh, so the stars aligned for you.
Pretty much. I think it did.
It seems as though it was destiny because you had that 1 year and then that 1 year became two. And suddenly you are now here, one of the biggest streamers here in the Philippines. What's been the most memorable moment for you so far here in your career as a streamer?
I think one of the most memorable would be just meeting people, not just fans. I love meeting fans. Like, it's just so surreal. Like, just somebody just goes to you and then asks for a picture or tells you that, hey, you saved me, or man, I keep watching you and all that stuff. You make me happy. It's just, man, I didn't know I could do that. And another thing that I really love is meeting my idols. So I've met like Hideo Kojima. So like I'm a huge fan of Metal Gear. I've met people who were actors to a certain video game, like Brian Deckard from Detroit Become Human. And I was able to meet up or connect with brands that would allow me to go to another country, so like Japan and all that. So it was just so surreal that I was doing this as a career. So yeah, it's just fun.
One of my favorite moments. You remember when PewDiePie wrote that comic?
Yes.
Remember that?
Yeah,
I watched that. I saw how emotional you got.
Yeah.
Can you take us back through that one?
So there was like this video where PewDiePie was asking for like tweets or something like that. You know, just a message. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe he wanted to feel good. And I just gave like a really heartfelt message on the comment section. For some reason, he noticed it and read it on another one of his videos, and people were going crazy. Because at that time, when the video came out, I was in my girlfriend's dormitory, and it was like the middle of the night, and my buddy Neil called me. He was like, go to PewDiePie's video, man. Like, you've been noticed. Your message was being read, and then people in Facebook was tagging me and all that. Like, what is happening?
Yeah.
And then I went to like, it was really crazy. I went to like the nearest computer shop, and then logged in, and then I saw it, and I was like, what the heck, dude? Like, oh my god! It was like a really, really big dopamine boost or shot.
Your hero. It's like your hero.
I'm getting goosebumps right now.
Yeah. You should see the video. It's super heartfelt.
The funny thing is, like, years later, just recently.
Recently?
Yeah, because PewDiePie finally moved into Japan. And I was just super happy for him because I haven't watched him in a while, but I really love watching his like Japan adventures and stuff. Made a comment like, hey, I'm happy for you and all that stuff. And then he hearted that comment. Yeah, that's how YouTube works. And the thing is, like, nobody else in the comment section got a heart except me.
You got the heart?
Yeah, so I was like,
hey, maybe GLOCO and PewDiePie in Japan?
It's coming.
Maybe we can make it happen.
Let's manifest hopefully, that. GLOCO and PewDiePie in Japan. If you met him, how would you feel?
That
if you
content actually is got cool.
I don't know. I don't think even if I see him, one of these, I don't think I'm worthy enough. You know, not yet.
No.
It would be cool though.
Feuds, if you're watching. To wrap up, man, where do you see yourself going in the next few years with your career? And what's your advice for those who want to take on the same route as you did?
So right now, just to be honest, like after everything that's been happening. Half of the time, I still don't know what I'm doing YouTube. I would say I'm one of the most unorthodox streamers or content creators at the moment when it comes to like the gaming side of YouTube. Because if you search gaming in the Philippines, like there are like a whole lot of bigger people out there than me. And the way I do things is just so different from how most content creators nowadays do it. So if I would give an advice, it really depends on like your goal when it comes to like being a YouTuber or content creator. If you want to be a content creator and grow really fast in numbers and all that stuff, don't do what I did. Don't do what I'm doing right now, because I'm very, very inconsistent with my content. The only reason why I think I still have a following or people still watch me is because I've already established something earlier. But if you do the same thing I did today, in today's environment or content creator environment, it's not going to work. So right now, it just really depends on your goal. Do you want to create a really wholesome, dedicated community, then yeah, you can do whatever I did and focus on having fun and enjoying what you're doing, whatever you plan on doing. But if you want numbers and all that stuff, you really have to like do the trends. You gotta follow through with the trends. Either that, or you create the trend.
Or create a trend.
Create a trend, like what Aria has been doing. So. Yeah, I would say content creating is more of like a science experiment. You know, you follow the scientific method of finding like a question and then making a hypothesis and then the actual experiment and finding a conclusion, and then it's just trial and error. And up till now, doing this for like 8, 9 years, I've lost count. I'm still learning. I'm still learning. So for those who are aspiring to be a content creator, just take it at your own pace. And then if you really want to be successful in this, in this line of work, you got to research a lot. There's going to be a lot of trials and errors, but, you know. And one more thing. Luck is a really, really underrated factor, but it is a factor. I consider myself very lucky. So, just get on with whatever you want to do. And just take note that the path or journey of every person is different. Okay, some goes to gets there really fast, some don't. Some takes like years. But as long as you're still enjoying, that's the most important thing. You're enjoying what you're doing. So, there.
No better advice than that. Just go at your own pace. GLOCO, this has been such a great conversation. Thank you so much for the advice as well. You are so relatable and so down to earth. My goodness, like you've been amazing. Thank you so much for your time. We're not done with you yet, though. Yeah. So if you just hang around, we have something for the end of this episode. Of course, watching other people play is fun, but we are all about improving ourselves and having our own fun, too. So let's head back and have another look at this episode's side quest.
Ready for round two, guys? If you fancy yourself a fan of Sir Conan Doyle and think you're ready to make an educated observation, we'll see you and your guests in the comments. But if you're not quite there yet, fret not, because we've got the second clue for all of you right here. Now, this game takes place in the years 872 to 878 AD and follows a fictional version of the Viking expansions into the British Isles. Players take the role of Ivor Byron's daughter, a raider who aims to establish a new Viking clan in England. Keep those guesses coming, guys, because you just might be right. But up next, we are going to be heating things up with our newest house party. This is a retro game character Pictionary, and GLOCO, you will be joining us for this one. Are you ready, sir?
I think I am.
Yes. Retro game.
They always think they're ready.
Yes, they always think they're ready. But you got this. She's excited. But ladies and gentlemen, all that and more when we come back with Gamer's Paradise.
We are not here on this planet to close our eyes to the world.
We are here to go out and experience its many wonders.
Because through our experiences,
we become bigger than ourselves.
Travel has the power to shape our world.
And make us whole again.
With 30 hotel brands and endless experiences, where can we take you?
I knew you guys weren't ready to tap out just yet. And if you are new around these parts and you're just tuning in, hey, it is a great time to have you with us. You've tuned into Gamer's Paradise, where we just explored Moxy Tokyo Kinshicho with Shinya Sunagawa before joining GLOCO and getting to know his incredibly epic career thus far.
But now, ladies and gentlemen, our journey is about to come to a climactic finish as these groups, Keiji, Aya, and GLOCO, will battle in a retro-style battle of Pictionary. Dun, dun,
dun, dun. So epic. All of your retro gaming knowledge will be put to the test right now for Pictionary right here on House Party.
So the rules are basically very simple. GLOCO, Aya, you guys are paired together. You have to show, of course, what you're drawing, and you have 30 seconds to whoever's guessing to guess what is being drawn. KG, you and I are teammates. We got this. We will win. We are connected.
I have my own over here, and I am so ready.
Mika, you're the game master. You're the game master. You can't play. I can still draw. Yeah, but
I can still draw.
But there's no point.
You're the game master. You're technically a game master too. Explaining the rules here, you get to join the game.
Boards were given to us.
I'm the game master.
You brought your
own
board.
Seem fair.
You have color coordinated markers.
Fair.
Okay, so let's keep this going. All right. So you guys are teammates. KG, we're teammates. 30 seconds to guess. And Mika, I believe you have the characters, correct?
I have a fishbowl full of retro gaming characters right here. You guys will be drawing out the character that you will be asked to draw on your boards.
Say, I love this this reverse triangle of power that KG is projecting.
I can do that.
That's how we do it. He's just like, let's go, my minions.
I can do it better.
Let's go.
All right.
I like
that's a sign of confidence.
I like this, sir. I like this. I feel it.
All right, I think you guys are ready. So why don't we start with our lovely guests over here on the couch first? Would you like to, how do we determine who goes, who wants to draw? Must be the artist.
I'm not so confident with my artistic skills, but in the name of fairness, we're going to let fate decide.
You're
gonna our flip coin eraser. Okay.
So smiley face is you.
And then black side.
Okay.
Here we go.
Let's go.
Let fate decide.
Flip it.
It's a smiley face.
Okay. Just means that you are in a smiley face.
That means I'm the one drawing.
Yes, you're the one drawing.
You know what? In another multiverse, it would have been Aya that went first.
It would have been Aya. She would have drawn something like
in universe,
like a scorpion or something.
Maybe. Maybe in another universe.
Or a caffeinated Mario.
Okay. There you go.
I would love to see that.
Yeah, I would love to see that.
Oh man.
Okay.
Please
do your
let
best
it be like
can't
a really
lose,
easy
you know?
One.
We're waiting a PlayStation 5, I heard.
So. Oh no.
Alright, here we go. Good luck.
This could be anything.
Oh yes.
Dude, that's
KG,
not,
we're doing good.
That's
doing
not
good.
Putting, that is so reassuring.
We're doing
this
good
could
so
be
far.
Anything.
Oh man.
This
all
could
right?
be anything is a really good
no,
okay.
It's, do not say those words.
All right, so,
okay.
So
do you guys have a clear view?
Do we have the
yes,
30
I
second
have a,
timer?
Ooh,
do we
I have can the 30 second clock? My multiverse drawing.
So we're going to count this down, okay? In 3,
okay.
2, 1, go.
Go.
30
go,
seconds.
Go. It's a leaf man. Is that Yoshi? Solid snake.
Okay.
Yoshi. Google Chocobo. Why does it look. Why does it look like that? What is that? Oh my god, you are bad.
I am bad.
That's
it. You don't have to like rub it in my face.
Is that Rampage?
Let's each other, KG.
Rampage. This is Yoshi.
It's Yoshi.
2, 1. Come on, it's Yoshi. Cannot not be Yoshi.
All right, is that correct?
Yes.
Is that the right
boom.
Answer? I'm just saying this is my Yoshi.
Right, I like hers better. I'm so
like,
sorry, Go.
I mean, man, I need to.
No, that's not a
Yoshi.
A frog.
That's a frog.
Okay, this is my
that
Yoshi.
Mutated to a Tyrannosaurus.
It looks. Rex. It looks like it's a very. This is a very. Look at this king.
This is a
this is abstract. Like, this
that's
will
a
sell
frog.
Like thousands of dollars in the right
it's,
place.
It's
so.
Like
this is
Mario
a Yoshi on something
multiverse.
I cannot say.
Okay, that's
Yoshi.
That's if a frog.
and a Tyrannosaurus Rex had a baby, and the baby bought sneakers.
Is that
that's
a
tongue.
Basically. It looks
yeah,
like a Wally Stumbo
fork tongue yeah. with an extra fork.
It looks like a Wally Stumbo.
But she got that.
Yeah,
though.
She got it like yeah. in the first like stroke. So
yeah.
I think yeah, yeah, I have credibility
okay.
now with that.
Okay,
I guess it's our turn, my friend.
You got the eyes.
All right.
You see this, sir? Right? We have 30 seconds to do this.
So bad.
Mika, go ahead and.
There's no justifying this. It's bad.
All right.
I'm so sorry.
Okay, here we go.
I will take over from now on. Kidding.
Okay.
The evil laugh. Why is that okay. laugh like that?
The evil laugh.
It's just so easy. Okay, here we go. Oh, wait.
Easy.
Wait, let me visualize.
Can I see?
Let me visualize.
Listen. Now I want to guess.
KG, from one man to another, you got this.
All right.
Here we go.
All right, your 30 seconds starts now.
Okay.
Oh, that's right. Mistake, sorry.
Okay, I have
okay.
Kind of baby. You get it?
I think I get it. Okay.
Okay,
my man.
Okay.
There you go. Look at that.
Dude, how could you not guess
there
that?
You go.
He did not Wait, even what? Make use of the screen.
Ah, okay, got this. Yep.
All right,
I see
time
it.
Okay.
I
see is it up, too. KG.
Okay.
Do you have any ideas?
KG, come on.
Come on.
Tazen, the singing vine.
That's not even a game, man.
Hold on. Wait. Aya? Is this a steal?
Teacher.
Is this a
teacher.
Steal?
What is it?
Teacher.
Is this a steal?
Yeah. Yeah.
What?
All
right,
all right. Idea. Let's say it together.
Tomb Raider.
Yes.
Perfectly in sync.
Lara.
You could say
it's Lara Croft for the reason that I...
That with the bridge, with the, you know,
right?
The,
yeah.
The details here.
Yeah,
it's Tarzan.
It's,
swinging,
it's the parkour,
yeah.
the gun.
This
Tarzan. Okay,
that.
This
yeah.
is
Tarzan
amazing.
Doesn't have a gun.
This is amazing. Despite Ares' abstract art,
yeah.
This team gets it correct. That was a steal. That puts you guys in the lead.
All of the elements are there: the gun, right. the ponytail, the parkour, and
I wasn't sure about the.
Did you like how the
definitely Spider-Man.
Do you like how they just overlap? Overlap.
Yeah.
All right, Aya, I think it is your turn
to
right
draw.
Now.
Yes,
it is your turn.
Finally.
Thankfully.
I hope I know the character, though. It would be a shame if I didn't.
Open to interpretation.
Okay, we got the next
She's
one.
An imposter. Oh my god!
Oh, she knows it.
No, I'm just bluffing.
Oh.
You're screwed.
Oh, no.
All right, okay. Your 30 seconds.
It's so hard to draw from.
Now.
30.
Okay.
Wow, that
I
is
can't see it. I don't be able to see.
Oh, God.
Wait. If she doesn't get it, I steal, right?
I think I know where this is going. But I want to let her finish the drawing.
I'm very invested. 10 seconds.
Okay. Red draw.
Wow, look at this.
Oh. I'm gonna put muscles in.
Wow.
What?
Wow.
Wait, 30 seconds.
One. And
one.
Oh, okay, it's Spyro.
Boom. Oh my gosh, this team is
We're a good
on
team.
A roll.
Hey, let's go.
Come on.
Okay?
Yeah,
the
like,
eyes are very buggy,
like
but yeah, I see it. I see it. If you can hold it up to the camera.
It's like he didn't
think
see
over
for
here.
How many days.
Yeah,
Multiverse
that's,
Mario, yeah.
That's Puyat's
I know what you're
yeah.
thinking.
It's like my
yeah. I can read your mind, Aries.
Yeah. That's Spyro that has multiple deadlines.
All right, KG, it is your turn.
KG,
but,
let's get it. So how many points do they have? They have 3 points?
They have 3 points.
They,
do. It's
okay,
quite
we got
a lead.
We got this.
It's quite a lead. But KG, I recognize the challenge over here, so I'm actually going to draw for you, and we're gonna do a little bit of magic over
right,
here.
I'm not gonna
like
look
the
here.
I don't know how to do this, but here, catch
KG,
it.
Do you see it?
Oh,
uh-huh.
Whoa,
it worked.
What
I knew
the?
It.
Whoa. What the?
What sorcery is this?
What in the multiverse of
work.
Madness?
How did you make it bigger?
What in Doctor Strange's name?
How did you make this bigger?
you sorceress.
It's the rate exchange in Singapore.
That's Singapore exchange. Paper exchange. It
gets bigger.
That's 32 pesos worth? Okay, yeah, I got it.
All right, KG, you have 30 seconds. Ready? Set.
Do you have your drawing materials? Drawing material?
Okay. He's getting ready.
Okay.
All right, he's ready.
I think it's
Oh.
Okay. Wait. Let me see it, my friend.
Wait.
Let me see it.
Show it.
Yeah. Okay, I got you.
Okay.
I got
ready,
you.
Set, go.
All right, my man. All right, I'm going to go closer. I can't see the drone, okay? All right. Okay. Okay. Oh. Okay. Okay, sword. Okay. Okay. Sword. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. A triangular hat. Okay.
If
that's a bomb, I got this.
10
that's
seconds left.
Link. Link Zelda. Legend of Zelda Link. Legend of Zelda Link.
Oh my
gosh. Is that
gosh,
it? That's
Harry
how we do it.
Harry got it.
That pot was a dead dude.
See?
How is that
See?
A link?
That's the Singapore and Philippine connection.
I mean, it's also the sword.
See? No, it's the bomb because I played Smash Brothers.
Link was my name. I thought it was a pot.
No, I was like, if that's a bomb, that's Link.
I thought it was a cauldron.
I thought it was a pot. Smash Brothers, Melee.
It's whatever you want. You got the right answer.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
That was a sword.
Okay.
High five.
Hey.
There is still a slim chance for your team to catch up should you steal this next round.
All right,
from this team.
Let's steal this.
Win the last one. So,
who's going to be drawing?
Baby, pick your best artist.
Gloco's
drawing. I think Gloco.
Definitely Aya is the best artist.
I was going to say Gloco's an experience. But
didn't Gloco just. Who drew Spyro?
Me.
Okay,
yeah.
So it's Gloco's turn.
Oh, you want?
This is the last round.
Oh, isn't it like switch?
Or maybe you could like choose.
Okay.
Like for the last
round,
I can choose who will
sounds
draw.
Good.
I mean,
sounds
like,
good.
It's like
fair,
a
fair enough. Let's give him.
Okay. All right. So who's drawing? Aya for the win then.
Okay. Wait. So who's drawing?
For the
you.
The people at home.
Yeah.
For the sake of the people at home.
This is the last round.
I am drawing.
The better
last round.
The gift
to take
over
people at home to enjoy some art.
That Spyro drawing was wonderful. Damn it.
All
right.
I'm so sorry.
Are you ready?
We're going for the steal here, KG. We're going for the steal.
Okay. 30 seconds. Aya starts now.
Throw it on the camera. Perfect.
No.
Okay. It's a mistake. It's a fumble.
Okay. Could be an alien. This is a spaceship.
Okay.
And I mean, okay. You gotta let me work more. Something here.
Five, four, three, two, one. Time is
alien invaders. Alien invaders, man.
Steal? Okay, KG, you want to steal?
No, wait, he said the answer. He said the answer.
Space
invaders.
Space invaders. We're going to have to go with KG, who had it exactly by the word. My goodness, that means that this team gets a steal.
We can win this! Let's go!
I didn't know space invaders.
I
know space invaders.
I just want to say this is my drawing, okay?
That looks like
Space invaders was like, that's at the top of my mind was like.
This is like,
it's
pixelated.
No, that's an Oompa Loompa from
Super
Mario.
It's pixelated.
that's kind of like that.
That's a
super. It's angry.
All right, so if we get this, we win.
Is there even a game called
Tie and then we call it.
No, you said
we call it a tie.
We call it a tie, and everybody's happy.
Okay, all right, here we go.
All right, Ari.
All right, wait, my man. Since you are the drawer, I'm gonna have you do this. I'm gonna have you do this. All right, I'm gonna get what you draw. So you draw for this round.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Yeah. All right, now we're gonna have to do this. This newfound exchange system right now.
Okay. Here we go. Oh my God.
Go.
Are you going to do this
here
again?
We're going to do it again. Ready? Here you go, KG.
There
you
go. Oh my God. The sorcery.
How did you
got
do
it?
How to do that, man?
How'd you do that?
I got to say, you know.
I'm so angry of how you can pull that off.
I know. So just saying, if you need anything shipped,
He's overseas.
Let me know.
Yes.
Know.
All right. Send something to
yeah,
Europe.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I need some garlic bits sent to. I need some garlic bits sent to Netherlands. Can you send that over?
All right, KG, are you ready? All set. All right, your timer starts now.
My man, let's
for
go.
The win.
For the tie. All right, let's go. I'm looking at you, sir. I see two eyes. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, okay. Okay, okay. Okay, I think I know this. Okay, okay, okay. Oh, what is this? What
the pixelated style? Okay, okay.
Oh my god, what is
could
this?
Be anything.
What?
10 seconds.
Oh my god.
What is that?
Oh. And your time is up.
I have Bomberman? Is it Bomberman? Is it Bomberman?
I think I have
is it?
I think I have an idea.
That's what I thought it was. It looked like a bomb.
All right. Donkey Kong. Do you want to venture a steal?
Okay. I want to steal.
We want to steal.
All right.
Oh,
we want to steal.
I know what it is.
Our steal is Donkey Kong.
Donkey Kong. Because of the barrel, right? Boom.
Oh, I thought it was a bomb.
It's a barrel. It's
it looked like
the barrel was the dead giveaway.
Yes. I'm like,
it was
there's
a barrel.
I thought it was Minecraft.
For the win. Aya and GLOCO takes Pictionary.
Let's go!
Did it!
They are the champions!
Woo! We're getting a PS5!
Well done!
I'm so disappointed in myself.
Are you okay, Ari?
I'm okay, I'm fine.
Yeah, yeah.
KG, you did that. I'm sorry. I thought it was a bomb. I thought it was like a roided up. I'm sorry. I thought it went to the gym.
my bad.
Aya, GLOCO, great job with just very entertaining. Entertaining indeed.
That was epic.
Ari, KG, thank you so much. But unfortunately, your artistic skills pale in comparison to Aya and GLOCO's over here. But Ari, we gotta recover from this because guess what? We are heading over to this time put our audience to the test in another edition of SideQuest.
All right, everyone, let's dive back into today's SideQuest. So, as we mentioned, this game features real-world historical events and figures, and it's been around for 15 years now. We also said it depicts an alternate history where the Vikings expanded their rule into British Isles, and you play Ivor, who contributes to those efforts. So,
I think you guys guessed it. Do you guys have an idea?
Okay, this is not Pictionary. The game is Assassin's Creed Valhalla, ladies and gentlemen. You guessed it right. That is it. And there you go. That is another thrilling entry for our saga for SideQuest. If you guys guessed it, congratulations. If you didn't, check it out. It is also a wonderful game if you haven't played it yet. So, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes, of course, SideQuest. And that is another fun episode for Gamers Paradise. Thank you so much, GLOCO. Thank you so much, Aya.
Thanks for having us.
KG, thank you so much. I love it. You know, we built up everything, all the action, even all the way from the Pulse.
Yes.
We got to know GLOCO, and it all came to head here in Pictionary and two very confusing clues by Ari Neiman.
Donkey Kong. KG, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry. I still think we had it, but we kind of let it go. It's fine.
But, ladies and gentlemen, if you guys want to, of course, suggest any theme or any games you'd like to do here at Gamers Paradise, do let us know in the comments. And, of course, you can also subscribe and check us out if you like what you saw for this episode. In the meantime, we hope you enjoyed our retro special. My name is Aaron Eman.
My name is Mika Fabs, and this has been Gamers Paradise.
No, but you knew it was Lara Croft, right?
It looked very questionable.
Come on, this is,
like, we were scared for our job.
It was a ponytail.
We
you
still
got it.
Have
the ponytail.
The ponytail, that was the gun.
We were gonna get
right?
The real gun.